Most of you probably know me by now, but for those of you who don't, I'm Cory, Brabon, and my final project, I did a computer. Well, basically a computer case. I built computers, sort of like an entrepreneur thing, and I thought it'd be a neat idea to like come up with my own design. And I started trying to come up with something new, because you know nowadays, like, well, ever since I was little, computers have always been the same, you know, it's like a rectangular box, so I tried to come up with a new design. My like design goals were improve the airflow, new age look, try to keep it smaller. You know, I had to make sure it was compatible with like hardware, which is sort of the big challenge in this project. Because, you know, I don't know if any of you do anything with computers, but if you go somewhere like new age, like everything's nice to fit together, and you know, you can't like just change everything, so. Yeah, I was researching just like basic computers. I did try to look for some different things. Like there's like the square computers. There were some other weird shapes, but these are the three I had on my reports. I just used these. This one was like, this is actually a decently expensive case. It's sort of like, I don't know, it's like $150, but like it's a really heavy case. Comes with like a lot of fans, but I sort of feel like it's a waste. But anyways, like, let's say I just, like, wrote down some, like, information on like, these kind of cases, like, rectangular, horizontal. They all have, like, horizontal airflow, aluminum plastic, especially, like, the cheaper ones can use a lot of plastic, so. Some pros. The shape allows for better storage. I don't know, I figure that's why they initially made computers like rectangular, so you can just sort of like store them, sort of like a book, and it fits under a desk, which is sort of nice. It can be very cheap to produce, you know, it's like when you're building stuff that's like circular, like, you know, designs can get more complicated, you know, it's just a rectangular, you can build it out of wood if you want, so, whatever. But, it fits components really well. Some other board, you know, it takes up a lot of space, and it's, you know, pretty much square, but all rectangular shapes, so it sort of makes sense. And there's a lot of variations of it as well. And cons, like I noticed like a lot of computers nowadays have overheating problems, especially with like more powerful computers than we have nowadays. You know, it's like people go to water cooling, you know, like, I say like we used to have like heating pumps because I don't like the way they do the airflow through like horizontally. I think it makes more sense for it to go up since heat rises naturally. So I don't think they look really appealing, but maybe it's because I've just been used to them my whole life. Yeah, a lot of them are really cheap nowadays too. Like whenever you work with them, like if you don't buy like a decent one, like you'll get like cut working with it, taking things apart. So you know, pour you some materials and not assembled sometimes. You know, it can be like bulky, sort of awkward, sometimes too big. And when I was coming up with alternate designs, you know, I just started doing random stuff, and I tried like sort of like a figure eight design. You know, they have like two bands. I tried like a pyramid one, it was sort of funky. And this is actually, I almost like this one a little bit more. Instead of knee, it was horizontal, but this found like a huge band back of the heavy center knee. But this one had complications. It's a little motherboard and such being too big. Go over that stuff. When I was like designing, when I was coming up with ideas, like my main goals was like keeping a new shape, you know, having some kind of decent airflow, and making sure like the size is compatible for parts nowadays. I did like a chart, but just some parts or ideas that would be important to me. And actually some of these all came out pretty close, with the exception of four. I don't have the pictures up, I apologize for that. But the first one is the one that I ended up designing, the circular one. The second one is the cylinder shaped one. The third one, third one is the figure eight, and the fourth one is the third one. I focus on size, airflow, power consumption, hard drive space, how much room would have for that, same with front drive space, looks, ease of assembly, connection ports. Which one to choose, I said, the spherical shape one. It seemed to be like the medium between all the cases, because it didn't necessarily have the most, it didn't have the best airflow to the circle like the second one did, but it fit everything a lot better, and it was smaller, like I could build it smaller. Especially by placing the motherboard in the center of the case, like, they keep like the size to about less than 20 inches. This is my final product, fender. You can see I put like locks on the sides, windows. I put the fan on top is actually pretty good. This is my outtake fan. I have two intake fans at the bottom of the case. The motherboard is upside down. This should be a better show. This is right over here, because I don't have enough. The motherboard will sit here, and the PCI slots are right here for your graphics cards, software cards, etc. It's cut off so you can't see what the rest of it would be, but there's another fan opposite. Hard drive is on top. PSU, power supply is there. Then there's only one complication I ran into while it's on yet. Is that I don't have enough room for a second CD or DVD ROM. So I can only put one, but I figure nowadays most pieces only have one, so I wasn't too worried about that. This is it, not rendered, but just sort of exploded. See like some of the parts. It's like, I built the hard drive because I wanted something else that was complicated, because like, I felt like everything was so spread out in the fans. Though they were really neat, you know, there still weren't a lot of parts and they weren't as complicated along yet, so I threw in the hard drives, which were interesting. And these are actually two of the fans, the two different types I made, and the hard drive, which I had most of my issues, well, that's still below the top line, but I had most of my issues with the hard drive. This shape in particular was quite a pain, getting the size correct, and ended up not putting a cover over it. Some of the other difficulties, specifically like the lower housing, is very difficult because like this curve I had to accommodate for all the designs that fit like modern hardware. You know, specifically the motherboard was a difficult design to fit. I wanted to keep the size down because, you know, you don't want a huge computer. Like, that's sort of annoying. I have a huge computer. It drives me nuts, so. And I figure with the design I have, like, you most likely won't stick it on the floor, it'll most likely be on your desk, so you don't want this huge server. Very interesting to come up with your own design and like implement it.